Hello, how's everyone? This is Lovely Waters, and I'd like to welcome you again. Once again, I'd like to welcome you to It's a New Day with Lovely Waters. Praise God. This is Resurrection Weekend, and I know everyone's excited, at least most everyone that I know. And I just want to bless each of you and wish you the most wonderful resurrection weekend ever. Amen. So praise God for his love. Amen. I'd like to say that our opening song will be sung by We the Kingdom. The song is entitled God So Loved. Our opening scripture is coming from John 5 and 24 through 29. And I want to say that our ending song will be one of my specials and one of my favorites, Waymaker by Cynic. I'd like to begin with our opening scripture. Amen. And our opening scripture is coming again from the book of John. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that heareth my word and believeth on him that sent me hath everlasting life, and shall not come into condemnation, but is passed from death unto life. For as the Father hath life in himself, so hath he given to the Son to have life in himself, and hath given him authority to execute judgment also, because he is the Son of Man. Marvel not at this, for the hour is coming in thee which all that are in their graves shall hear his voice, and shall come forth, they that have done good unto the resurrection of life, and they that have done evil unto the resurrection of damnation. And so that came from John 5, amen, 24 through 27. Now let's move forward, and I would like to say that I'm very just excited about this weekend. So we're going to have a short prayer today, and I'm going to pray like I used, as long as I used to, because I have so much to get to. But if you'd like to bow your head with me, that'll be wonderful. If not, I just pray that I invite you before the presence of the Lord. The scripture tells us, let us come boldly before the throne of grace, that we might obtain mercy and grace in the time of need. Father, we thank you. And Father, we thank you alone. For Lord, we know that our lives are in your hand. Father, we realize, oh God, that it truly is in you that we move, that we breathe, that we have our being. Father, we thank you, oh God, for being such a loving Father. And Lord, we celebrate you, Father. We celebrate Jesus. Father, we thank you, oh God, for life today through Christ our Savior. And Lord God, we glorify you, oh God, for this resurrection time of year. Although every day, what makes it so wonderful, Father, is that you rose for us each and every day. At every hour, we bless you, Jesus. And so we ask you, oh God, to let your word, Lord Jesus, hallelujah, fall, and Lord, let it roll, oh God, like a mighty stream. Father, we pray today that it will, Lord, that your word, Lord, will spread all around the world today. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, then. So I did want to start out saying that have a blessed resurrection weekend. And our lesson, our message is entitled today, No Greater Love. Jesus was love. God is love. Jesus was and is still alive today. He lives. He lives. He lives. Jesus lives. And he lives in me. and he lives in many of you. He was the way. He was the way maker, for he still is the way maker. For he opened the greatest door of all, which gave us eternal life. When the greatest door of all was opened, his salvation flooded the world. When the women went to the tomb, the door was rolled open. This was the door for all mankind to receive salvation. Jesus said it himself, I am the door. You know, I started last week talking about doors and how the Spirit of God has just been magnifying and highlighting the significance of doors. Amen. Jesus opened the door. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, I just bless his name. I bless his name every time I think about his name. Praise God. I know there's power in his name. Amen. So I want to go on to John 20 and 1. Amen. John 20 and 1 tells us these scriptures. And at 1, it says, the first day of the week cometh Mary Magdalene. She came early when it was yet dark unto the sepulchre, and she seeth the stone taken away from the sepulchre. Then she runneth and cometh to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and said unto them, they've taken away the Lord out of the sepulchre, and we know not where they've laid him. And Peter therefore went forth and with the other disciple, and came to the sepulchre. So they ran both together, and the other disciple did outrun Peter, and came first to the sepulchre. And he, stooping down, looking in, saw the linen clothes lying, yet went he not in. Then cometh Simon Peter, following him, and went into the sepulchre, and seeth the linen clothes lie, and the napkin that was upon his head, not lying with the linen clothes, but wrapped together in a place by itself. Then went in also that the other disciple, which came first to the sepulchre, and he saw and believed. For as yet they knew not the scripture, that he must rise again from the dead. Then the disciples went away again unto their own home. But Mary stood without, meaning outside of the sepulchre. She was weeping and weeping. And as she wept, she stooped down and looked into the sepulchre and seeth two angels in white sitting there, one at the head and the other at the feet. And she was continually weeping. And then she said, where is the body of Jesus? Where has it been lain? They said unto her, woman, why weepest thou? And she said unto them, because they have taken away my Lord, and I know not where they've laid him. And when she had said this, she turned herself back and saw Jesus standing, and knew not that it was Jesus. Jesus said unto her, woman, why weepest thou? Whom seekest thou? She, supposing him to be a gardener, said unto him, sir, if thou have borne him thence, tell me where thou hast laid him, and I will take him away. Jesus said unto her, Mary. And she turned herself and said unto him, Rabboni, which is to say, Master. And Jesus said to her, touch me not, for I am not yet ascended. For I have not ascended to my Father, but go to my brethren, and say unto them, I ascend unto my Father and your Father, and to your Father, to my Father and to your Father, excuse me, and to my God and your God. Mary Magdalene came and told the disciples that she had seen the Lord and that he had spoken these things to her. Then the same day at evening, being the first day of the week, when the doors were shut, where the disciples were assembled, for fear of the Jews, came Jesus and stood in the midst and said unto them, peace be unto you. All right. So we see here that God had raised his son from the dead. Praise God. And you know, I had a couple of videos before, I was really meditating on John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever, he gave his only son, that whosoever believeth on him would not perish, but have eternal life. All right. Amen. So I wanted to say that Jesus came to fulfill his Father's will for the world. He was on purpose. Jesus came on purpose, as well as everything that preceded him. John the Baptist said in response to the Pharisees, coming from St. John 1, beginning at 25. And it goes something like this. When the Pharisees were talking to him and questioning him about who he was, John the Baptist said, they asked him, and they said unto him, why baptizest thou them if thou be not the Christ, nor Elias, and neither that prophet? John answered them, saying, I baptize with water, but there standeth one among you whom ye know not. Talking about Jesus. Hallelujah. He it is who cometh after me, who's preferred before me, whose shoes latcheth I am not worthy to unloose. These things were done in Beth Abara, beyond Jordan, where John was baptizing. The next day, John seeth Jesus coming unto him and saith, behold the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sins of the world. This is he of whom I said, after me he cometh, a man which is preferred before me. For he was before me, and I knew him not, but that he should be made manifest to Israel. Therefore am I come baptizing with water. This is John. And John bare record, saying, I saw the Spirit, he said, descending from heaven like a dove, and it abode upon him. And I knew him not, but he that sent me to baptize him with water, the same said to me, he's testifying, upon whom thou shalt see the Spirit descending and remaining on him, the same is he which baptizeth with the Holy Ghost. And I saw and bear record that this is the Son of God. All right, you guys, I tell you, it's just so good when we talk about, hallelujah, Jesus, and we talk about, amen, hallelujah, this story. Because I mean, brothers and sisters, this is the redemption story. It is Christ's death, his burial, and his resurrection. It is a story of Christ's love for his Father and God's love for the world. John 15 and 13 says, greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. I want you to think about it. Our message is entitled, No Greater Love. We in all of our lifetime, we will never come across a love like the love of God. For truly the love of God, hallelujah, was bright, it was shining, it was living, it was life, it was light before the foundation of the world. Amen. And it is now, even now, today, 2022, even now, faith, we are more than conquerors through Jesus Christ. We must meditate on his promises. Promises of love toward us when we feel defeated. Amen. His promise toward us is true. It's faithful. Hallelujah. And it's love. There's no greater love. Amen. When our friends and family are gone, we must meditate on this truth. When our health is failing us, by remembering Isaiah 53 and 5 that says, but he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes, we were healed. With his stripes on Calvary, we were healed. Every blood, hallelujah, stain that rolled down his body, hallelujah, healed us. And not only were we healed, hallelujah, but we are healed today. We are delivered. We have provision. We are not alone. His word, hallelujah, is still marching on. His blood has avenged us of our enemies. Our children have been given salvation. When we are in trouble, the Holy Spirit is a waymaker. Psalm 138 says, God will perfect everything that concerns you and me. God's word says that he would be gracious unto us when he hears the voice of our cry, and he would answer. So I am so blessed today when I think about, praise God, what God has done for me. I am thankful today that I still have life. I'm thankful today that God gave me so many promises. So many promises. I mean, I have so many, I can't tell it all. But I know that God is who he say he is. Not, hallelujah, because what somebody else said. But I know that God is who he said he is because of what he has done for me. And I believe that he will do the same for you. That's why I'm here today. If I did not believe that God was real, if he had not revealed himself to me, and if I did not believe that he is a God that has no respect of person, I would not be here today referring you to Jesus. Oh, yes, I recommend Jesus. Whatever you're going through, no matter what it looked like, keep on crying out to the Master. Keep on knocking at his door. Amen. Keep on trusting. Hallelujah. Keep on, hallelujah, going forward before his throne of grace. I want you to know today that Jesus told me to come today to remind you. All right. Amen. He sent me. Amen. I know, and I thank God I can truly say I've been sent. We had a little bit of technical difficulty there, but we're gonna finish strong. Amen. Praise God. God is with us. Praise God. And he wanted me to just let you guys know that he, praise God, is available. God is always available. Praise God. For you, for me, for the world. No matter where you are in the world. All he expects is just a little bit of faith. Amen. Praise God. So I just want to end by saying that I want you all to begin. And this is something that God just dropped in my spirit. God wants us to become more grateful. I know we've had COVID-19, the pandemic. We've had political issues, and we've always had political issues, and we always have political issues until Jesus come back. Amen. I mean, we got the Gaza Strip, we've got the war in Ukraine, we've got politics here, the economy. We got so many things in our community that are not right. But God and the schools are having issues. Children's the quality of education is lacking. Praise the Lord. We got people that are walking around every day killing other people. We've got children that are growing up too fast. Praise the Lord. We've got so many things. We got masks that we have been forced to use, although they have been for our good, that people are grumbling about that. We grumble, 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 grumble. But God sent me to say, be grateful. Let's take on a spirit of gratefulness. That's even though sometimes, you know, the enemy will steal our thoughts when it comes to being grateful. We just seem like we just can't think. Just start little. Lord, I thank you that you blessed me to see the sunshine today. Lord, I thank you I'm not in the hospital sick. I thank you I'm not in ICU. Lord, I thank you, Lord Jesus, that you watched over me and my family all night long. Lord, I thank you that we got food on the table. And if you don't have food, just say, Lord, I believe that you said that you would supply all of our need according to your riches in glory through Jesus Christ. So, Lord, we're waiting for the food because we believe it's on the way. Amen. We want to thank God and say, Lord, I thank you that you sent me a word so that I know I have a word to proclaim and declare so that I can get what I need. Amen. That's gratefulness. I'm grateful, praise God, that you watched over my prayers. I'm grateful that, Lord, I still have a heart and a mind and a spirit to trust you for even those prayers that I still am waiting for the answers to. Let's be grateful, praise God. But number one, let us thank God. That we and be grateful for our Savior. That we have a Savior. Amen. Because if it had not been for the Lord on our side, praise God. Oh my God. I don't know where we would be. Amen. Don't want to think about it. I'm grateful today. I'm grateful for this channel today. To be able to send his word around the world. Amen. I'm grateful, praise God, that I can speak, that I can sing, I can dance, that I can walk on my own, that I can eat on my own, that I can praise God on my own, that I can speak and declare the word of God. Hallelujah. That somebody can hear me and somebody will be given an opportunity to be saved. Have a blessed resurrection weekend, and somebody go to church. Amen. Don't be getting caught up in what you got on, just long as it's clean. Amen. That's all that matters. Jesus wants us to come as we are. At least we have an opportunity. The churches are open now. Amen. The churches are back open again. We can go to church. We may not, some churches may not still be open, but it's more churches open now, I mean, that have been in a very long time. We can be grateful that COVID-19 is at its low. And it's not at its high as it has been. Amen. That's something. I know I'm grateful for that. I'm so grateful that we can even go in places now and not have to wear a mask. And to where we don't have to be, you know, covered up with a mask. You know, I was telling one young lady in the mall the other day, I was like, you know, I didn't have my little mask on, and you know, I was so excited. I was just sitting there on the little bench, and the other little girl came up and sat across the bench beside me, and I just smiled and smiled and smiled. And she looked at me like, that lady's really smiling. And I told her, I said, well, I'm just smiling. I said, because I've been wearing that mask so much until now, I can really smile, you know. And so it even gave me, you know, this pandemic and wearing the mask gave me a new appreciation. Praise God, to be able to smile, because with those masks, you don't know whether somebody's smiling or really smiling or just, you know, whatever. But nevertheless, you know, let us be grateful. God wants us to be grateful. Amen. And don't get caught up in what you have on this Sunday. Amen. And those who are not able to go to church, praise God, be accepting that God is at all times, everywhere. There's no place where God does not dwell. Amen. He's right there. Amen. If you are bedridden, He's right there. All you got to do is call Him. Amen. And amen, He will be there for you. Amen. So I just want you guys to know, amen, that God loves you. Amen. And I know I get carried away, but I just came to bring you, praise God, the unadulterated truth of God. I'm excited about Jesus, our Savior. I'm excited about His resurrection story, and it restores me when I meditate on it. It restores me when I think about that His stripes were for a purpose. His stripes were so that we might be healed, that we might be set free. Amen. The redemption of Christ's redemption, it sets all mankind free. We all want to be free. Everybody in this world wants to be free from something. Well, I want you to know that Jesus will make you free. His word, the word that I've shown you today, shall make you free. Praise God. So I just want to say goodbye, and I want to say bless each of you, and have a blessed Resurrection Sunday. This is Lovely Waters saying, praise God once again, in Jesus' name.
Touching every life, I worship you. I worship you. You are here, meeting every need. I worship you. I worship you. Oh, devotion, dear, my Zekeanne.